स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं।
How to start meditation? At what age one should start meditation? You are in right place. You will have the answer in few minutes. We will enter into the technique. Come for tomorrow and day after tomorrow sessions too. We will be entering into the deeper and deeper levels of methods and techniques. We always dream because we are away from reality. Or try to achieve dream reality. If we do not dream, then what is life? This is one of the worst lie taught to you. Because your universities and schools and societies are not able to teach you superconscious state, they taught you daydreaming state. Understand? Just because they are not able to teach, just because they compromised, let you not waste your life, let you not miss the truth, let you not miss the reality. Life can be lived without daydreaming, with superconscious vision. I always tell people, with daydreaming, these desires, before fulfillment, they will give you a deep restlessness. After fulfilling, suddenly you will see they are showing you emptiness. With vision, means superconscious lifestyle, thoughtless awareness lifestyle, before fulfilling, those visions will empower you, will show you the direction. After fulfilling, they will give you a deep satisfaction. There is a big difference between daydream life and superconscious life. There is only two choices. Either you will live a superconscious life or daydreaming life. If you are not living a superconscious life, be sure you are living a daydreaming life. But there is a great fear. If I stop daydreaming, how will I do next planning? How will I decide how to invest? How will I decide what my plans should be next? How will I invest? How will I decide what my life should be? If it is not there, what will you do? Sometimes, if your workers or subordinates convince you, without them your business cannot run. If you are convinced, they will start exploiting you. Same way, your mind has convinced you, without it, you cannot run your life. That conviction is what I call suffering. That is what I call the root of suffering. I tell you, when I say, I really mean, you can live without your daydreaming. You may ask, then how will I plan for my tomorrow? Usually, you are not planning, you are worrying. You are not planning, you are worrying. And even by your planning, you are only reproducing your past into the future. You are limiting your growth by planning. Because you do not have courage to live with the spontaneity, to live with your spontaneous visions happening, to live with the spontaneous revelations happening, constantly you are struggling with your day-to-day planning and your life. People who had courage to trust their vision, their spontaneity, only they became genius. Only they became genius. Please understand, a little courage to enter into the life without daydreaming can just revolutionize. I can say this is what I call psychological revolution. Just try for 10 days. In 10 days, I don't think your whole life will be taken away from you. In 10 days, if it can be taken away, then it is not worth having. Let it be taken away. So just try for 10 days, life without daydreaming. Suddenly you will see the quality of spontaneity, and every one of you are visionaries. Because of your planning and daydreaming, the quality of having visions is suppressed. If you just remove the daydreaming, if you just remove the daydreaming and have little courage towards that quality of creating visions in you, quality of living with the spontaneity, you will see suddenly the visionary in you is awakened. People who live with super consciousness never fail and miss in their decisions, because the depth of dilemma or the oscillation, mood swings will be very less. It will be very limited. When the mood swing and the depth of dilemma is limited, suddenly you will see so much of energy is saved and decision making becomes so sharp and straight. I always tell people, having freedom without intelligence is the worst suffering. Whenever this thousands of people are living in our ashrams around the world, when they don't listen to what I say, I tell them, all right, give him freedom. That is the worst suffering. That is the worst punishment. Just by the dilemma, he will die. Just by the dilemma, he will die. Nothing else needs to be done. Without intelligence, when the freedom is given, it will lead only to suffering. Our daydreaming is also nothing but dilemma. The intelligence is not there, but the freedom is there. That is what I call daydreaming. Somebody is asking, is a blissful state in one in which breathing pattern changes, it's deep and slow, and I can feel a wave of energy on the face, is this a blissful state? I can say this is one of the symptoms of the blissful state. In the blissful state, actually the breathing pattern changes and the whole body feels the wave. This is one of the symptoms of the blissful state. This question I answered. We always dream because we are away from reality, or try to achieve dream reality. If we do not dream, then what is life? So, only kids need to dream to cope up with the reality. Even after growing, if you have to dream to cope up with the reality, we are mentally retarded. We have not grown. After the childhood or beyond the childhood, can the experience of enlightenment be transferred through touch? Can I enter the Turiya state under the influence of the master? It is possible. From time immemorial, the first gift was always given by the push from the master. But to stay in that same state You yourself should have gone through the psychological revolution. Ramakrishna was able to give only one glimpse to Vivekananda. But Vivekananda has to go through the psychological revolution to retain it. So, the experience can be given, a glimpse can be given by the touch of the master. But if you need to retain it, surely you yourself need to go through that psychological revolution. Means living these great truths in reality. If a person focuses on his work with intensity, does that person need meditation? This is again a hypothetical question. If a person focuses his work, nobody can focus without meditation. So if you think, if a person focuses, actually the question with if cannot be answered. The question with if cannot be answered. It is like a hiding. It is like if it is. If it is, the if it is cannot be added. If it is cannot be answered. Will meditation in the beginning produce any bad side effects? No. No side effect except bliss and health. Is there any meaning in the dream I am seeing? There is no meaning even in the world which you are seeing. What about the dream? Even the world which you are seeing has no meaning. So forget about the meaning of the dreams which you are seeing. People come and ask me, Swamiji, I saw this dream, I saw such and such a dream, please give me the meaning about it, explain. I tell them, Are the world which you are seeing is itself is useless. So why waste time in interpreting the dreams? There is something called placebo effect. Understand? If patient and doctor, both of them does not know, the medicine is given, if some color water is given instead of medicine, and not only the patient should not know it is just water, even doctor should not know it is just water. Both of them should be thinking it is a medicine, but the person gets healed. He gets the same effect of medication. This is called placebo effect. The same placebo effect, the reverse placebo effect. There is a theory, reverse placebo effect. What you know? In the West, this calamity happens. In the East also, it has started. Continuously advertising about some symptoms of disease. If you have a slight knee pain, it may be arthritis. Some 5-6 symptoms, a very broad symptoms if you give. And ask, if you have any one of these symptoms, you have this mental disorder. You will see 95% of the people will start feeling that they have that mental disorder. Now it's true. Morning, slow lethargy or irritation in your relationships, feeling like disconnected or loneliness. If you have any one or all the symptoms, you have this mental disorder. Who will say, I don't have? And these idiots go on preaching this nonsense. When these ideas are constantly told to the public, told to the people, they start believing that they do have that disease. Understand one problem. If there are 10 symptoms, and if you start connecting with the disease by saying you have one symptom, you will create all other 9 symptoms within few days. Because you are clearly, strongly believing you have that disease now. You have to express other symptoms, otherwise something is wrong. You will start thinking, oh God, other symptoms are not there, then something is wrong with me. So giving these broad symptoms and asking you to choose, if you have any one or all the symptoms, you have this disease, is the worst calamity. Actually, this is what I call reverse placebo effect. In the first placebo effect which I explained, The healing happens. In this placebo effect, disease happens. In the West, oh God, of course, the East also. Of course, the Indian cities are no more Bharat. Unfortunately, we have to tell the truth. Geographically, maybe Bharat, but the great value, the great lifestyle is slowly. Anyhow, but at least if you have intelligence, stop allowing these thoughts getting into your system. Stop allowing, especially the symptoms related to mental disorder. See, every season, every once in 3 months, in the West you will see one new diagnosis. And you will see 30% of the country is suffering with the disease. And 27% of the country is suffering with the disease. I'm surprised. The moment you come out with some symptom, naturally what people will think? I think I have little irritation. 2-3 times I shouted. I do have that symptom. You just connect with your activity and attitude and see. If some one symptom clicks, then what happens? You start visualizing from next day all other symptoms are there in your life. And you connect every incident in your life and see. And you have now, you are very clear, now you have that disease. So I feel the very idea from which we look has to be shifted, has to be changed. All they missed is health, that's all. They missed an important idea, important truth, the healthy part of the human being they missed. Consciousness is the healthiest part of the human being. They are not interested in accepting that. Because if they, the moment they accept that, they give the hope to the human being, they can heal themselves. They don't need the help of somebody else. Then problem starts. People come and ask me many times, why should we go to the gurus? We have become dependent on masters. At least master will liberate you at some point. Master basically trusts there is a part in you which cannot be occupied or possessed by disease. What is the fastest way to spiritual progress? Shortcut. If you want an honest answer, I should say, I don't know. I don't know is the honest answer. Because according to me, the spiritual life itself is the simple straight path. See, shortest distance between two points is a straight line. So there is no more, there cannot be any other shortcut. Shortest distance between two points is straight line. So I can say spiritual life is straight line. That is the straightest line. That is only shortest route. Please put some light on what is it that tells me that I had a good sleep in the night. Maybe the time you spent in the deep sleep was more than time you spent in dream state. That is what you feel morning, that you had good sleep or rest. Swamiji clarified that there are so many methods of meditation. Which is the excellent method? I can say I have chosen three methods, three techniques. These 3 days you will be learning. Today it will be like a preparation, introduction, entering into meditation. Tomorrow it will be deeper, cleansing. And day after tomorrow, deepest level, unclutching, means experiencing the true self. So, we'll enter into the meditation. Just these few questions I'll attend, then we'll enter into the meditation. These are the questions: how long we can meditate at a stretch, how to come out from the thought flow. All these questions will be answered now in the meditation when I explain the technique. Whatever questions I am going to answer now when I explain the technique, I am not answering. Other things I'll answer. Does not living in high intensity cause tiredness? No. Living in high intensity costs more energy. How do we know that there are only four states of being? If there's some process for this, something, what if there are 10 states? Don't bother. If there are 10 states, I will have 7-day classes. There are only four states, that is why I have 3-day classes. Don't bother about it. I think now working on the fourth state is more than enough. If there are 10 states, maybe after you see the fourth state, we can start looking into it. Many times dreams are considered to be the symbolizers of future happenings. Then what the dream is? I don't think your dream should be symbolizing your future. Your future is not that bad or that low that it can be predicted and planned in your dream. It should be predicted and planned in your waking state. Understand? If you are future is planned and predicted in the waking state, you know where you are going. If it is predicted and planned in the dream state, understand, where are you going? Where are you heading? You don't even know where you are heading. I think it is very dangerous. Better not to be planning and predicting your future in the dream state.